A potter is a master.
Yes.
Because he has vision about what he's trying to create.
Wow. Woo, that's good, man.
And God is a master potter today.
Yes.
He's got vision about what he's trying to create in you.
Yes.
See, all you sometimes, Elrod, come on, get here. Come on, help me out. All you can see sometimes, pour that in you. All you can see sometimes is this. All you can see is power.
Yeah.
You don't see the finished product.
That's right. That's right.
Well, I'm gonna help somebody there.
Yes. Yes.
But see, this illustration is coming to help you see that there's a finished work in
Woo!
You.
Yes.
See, God has already completed the finished work.
Yes.
Now you're going through the process of walking out the finished work.
Wow.
See, the way God sees you, he sees you completed him.
Yeah.
He sees you finished in him. He sees you whole in him. He sees you healthy and wealthy in him.
Yeah.
He sees you, amen, not depressed, but he sees you blessed.
Yeah.
He doesn't see stress on your life.
Yeah.
He sees stress being relieved and released
yes.
from your
yes.
life.
Yes, yes.
The problem is, are we seeing it like God sees it?
Yes.
Come on, say pottery is messy.
Pottery is messy.
Say it's messy.
Messy.
But it's necessary.
But it's necessary.
See that woman at the well, she had a mess going on in her life. It was a mess going on in her life. But it was a necessary mess. Because God, Jesus decided, you know what? I'm going to put my hands on your life. And when Jesus put his hands on that woman's life, her life changed.
Yeah. Yeah.
I said, when Jesus put his hands on that woman's life, her life changed.
Yeah.
How do you want your life to change?
Yeah.
See, you got to allow your heart to remain in the potter's hand.
Yes.
Come on, Elrod, let's pull them away here. Amen. Now notice, one thing about pottery is that it takes two or three times before it gets right. Pull some more. Pastor, let me hold that. Somebody give me that bottle of water. He's gonna get it. All right. It takes more than one attempt to make something right. Amen. Because what happens is, when you're making pottery, sometime the potter discovers some things. Amen. He discovers that some of the pottery has some imperfections.
Wow.
In the process of God remaking you, reshaping you, amen, there's some imperfections. See, when you got born again, when you got saved, the first time you accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior of your life, amen, God began to pull away those rough areas in your life. And what he discovered was that, you know what? As he was forming you and delivering you from the things that was going on in your life at the time, he discovered there were some rocks in there.
Mm.
There were some stumbling blocks in there.
Mm.
There was some stuff, amen, that was preventing you from being who God created you to be. See, and you need God's hands on your life to be able to know what needs to be out of your life.
Yeah.
Some of us are trying to hold on to people and things that need to be out of our life. Some of us don't want to listen to the word of God because our heads are hard like a rock. But God is saying, amen, if you're going to be shaped like me and like I want you to be, amen, your head can't be hard as a rock. Your heart can't be hard as a rock. I come to look to take the rocks out of you so that I can have a pliable heart. A pliable heart means a heart that I can reform and reshape.
Yes. Jesus. Mm.
Tell your neighbor, God wants to reform you.
God wants to reform
you. He wants to reshape you. Now, I need some more water, Elrod. But Gilgooks, no, that's good. This should be enough water. That's good. All right, pour it in there. Yeah. Sometimes you need some water, amen? In order to push it back down and build it back up again. But the water always represents the Holy Ghost.
Holy Spirit. Yes! Come on, Pastor.
Did we not read in Joel? And did we not read in David's words in Psalm 51? Did not David say, withhold not your spirit from me, hide not your presence from me? In other words, pour all the water on me, God, that you want to pour. Pour all the anointing on me. make me into who you want me to be. My mind is clay for you to make me who you want me to be.
Yes.
See, when you got that type of attitude, amen, you don't worry about what you're wearing, because you know that when the Lord has brought you from, you don't worry about what people say about you, but you know where the Lord has brought you from. You're a work in progress, baby. I said you're a work in progress. Come on, tell yourself, I'm a work in progress. And the Lord said, not only a work in progress, but a working process.
Wow.